Hello friends, welcome to a new lecture on persistent priapism. Here the penis is erect and it is painful. That is, persistent painful erection of penis is called as priapism. Persistent painful erection of penis is called as priapism. Okay, here what are the causes of persistent painful erection of penis? So if this is the penis, I wanted to change the color. Okay, now this is the corpora cavernosa, which occurs in the middle of the penis. Okay, so this corpora cavernosa will help in venous drainage of the penis. And this is the prostate, which is present on either side of the vagina, on either side of the urethra. And these are the venous plexus, prostatic venous plexus. Okay, so why is priapism developed? The main etiology is whenever there is thrombosis in the corpora cavernosa, or in the either there may be thrombosis in corpora cavernosa, or there is thrombosis in the prostatic venous plexus. Either there is thrombosis in the corpora cavernosa or thrombosis in the prostatic venous plexus, then the blood from the penis cannot drain posteriorly, and as a result it cannot drain. As a result, it can cause the blood which is present in the penis, that will cause engorgement of the penis, leading to painful erection of the penis. There is one more disease, which is sickle cell anemia. So in sickle cell anemia, the sickling cell, the cells are sickled, and these sickled cells may block the corpora cavernosa, and thus preventing the drainage of the blood, of the distal blood of the penis, and as a result resulting in enlargement. Sometimes resulting in erection. Sometimes even there can be some secondary deposits in the corpora cavernosa due to some disease. You know, some diseases, some cancers. So there can be secondary deposits in the corpora cavernosa. So these secondary deposits will also prevent the blood from draining into the into the subsequent veins. So how are you going to treat it? And there is one more condition where we use, whenever the patient uses therapeutic injection of papaverin, even this can cause persistent priapism. What are the treatment aspects, how are you going to treat it? First, you can insert a needle into the corpora cavernosa, and you can aspirate the blood so that the engorgement is relieved. So that is aspiration of sludged blood, that is the blood which has been present over there for longer period. So such sludged blood in corpus cavernosa. This is corpus. Okay, corpus cavernosa should be done. If this fails to cause detumescence, then you can inject metararminol 1:1 lakh. Okay, this can be effective, and even this will not cause any detumescence, or this will not decrease the engorgement of penis. Then you will have to anastomos corpora spongiosum and corpora cavernosa. Corpus spongiosum and corpora cavernosa. So these cats should be anastomosed. Okay. So this is about persistent priapism. I think you guys have understood about persistent priapism. So thank you guys for watching my lecture. If you have any doubts, please comment it in the comment section. If you feel something is inadequate in this lecture, even then comment it in the comment section. Thank you for